Hi everyone, marhaba, this is Sharik and welcome back to another lesson with Globetrot with Arabic. Today's lesson is going to be a Lebanese Arabic lesson to my Lebanese Arabic students from Oxford Street. As you can see, the decoration is very beautiful because Christmas is almost here. We're only 1 month away from Christmas and the shops are so beautiful with their lights, with their decorations. So let's say, first of all, that Christmas has approached. That's how we say it in Lebanese Arabic. Arab, Eid al-Milad, Arab. Arab, it means he approached or it approached. And then we say Eid al-Milad, Eid al-Milad. Milad in Arabic means birth. Al-Milad means the birth. Eid al-Milad means Christmas. It's like you are saying the Eid, the celebration of the birth, and it's the big birth, the birth. That's why we say Eid al-Milad. But don't confuse this to Eid Milad, because Eid Milad without il means birthday, Eid Milad. And Eid al-Milad means Christmas. So if you want to say Christmas is almost here, all you need to say is Arab Eid al-Milad. Eid al-Milad approached, Christmas approached. Let's say the street is decorated. الشارع مزين 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 means decorated in the masculine form. In the feminine form you would say مزينة. So الشارع مزين. But if it's more than one street you would say الشوارع الشوارع مزينة. So الشارع مزين الشوارع مزينة. And if it's decoration you would say زينة زينة. And Christmas decoration is Zinat Eid al-Milad. Zinat Eid al-Milad. So Zine, when it's alone, it has this T marbuta, the T sound that is mute, we don't pronounce it Zine. But the moment you follow it by Eid al-Milad, you can't say Zine Eid al-Milad. You have to say Zinat Eid al-Milad. So Haydi Zinat Eid al-Milad. This is the decoration of Christmas. Let's say there are lots of lights. في كثير أضوية. ضو in Arabic means light. أضوية means light. في كثير أضوية. I also want to say the street is lit up. الشارع مضوى. مضوى is the adjective. So ضو is light. أضوية is light. And مضوى is the adjective, it's lit up, mdawwa. And if it's feminine, you would say mdawwey. So the street is lit up, you would say الشارع mdawwa. And if it's plural, you would say الشوارع mdawwey. Let's walk around and let's see what is there in this beautiful street. يلا بس ناطرة الضوء الأخضر. ناطرة الضوء الأخضر. ناطرة, I'm waiting because I'm using the feminine form. ناطرة. ناطر is I'm waiting if it's masculine. ناطرة الضوء الأخضر وهيدا الضوء الأخضر. And this is the green light. الحقني الحقني means follow me. Oh, it's much easier when somebody is recording you. الحقني. So نحن هلا, we are now, نحن هلا حد Selfridges, next to Selfridges. نحن هلا حد Selfridges. Selfridges هو مول. It's a mall. Selfridges هو مول كتير كبير. It's a very big mall. وفيه محلات كتيرة. Selfridges mall كتير كبير. وفيه, it has in it, فيه محلات, shops. فيه محلات كتير كبيرة. مثلا هون في سيارة بورش. في سيارة, في سيارة بيضة. سيارة بيضة. And if I want to say it's a Porsche car, I would say سيارة Porsche. So you see the difference? When I'm not following the word with the word Porsche, I'm just saying في سيارة. But when I'm following it with the word Porsche, I'm saying في سيارة Porsche. But look at the difference between these two sentences. The first one I said في سيارة بيضة, there is a white car. And in the second one I said في سيارة Porsche. Why is the difference? Why did I not pronounce it the first time and then the second time I pronounced the T marbuta? Why? Can you guess? It's because بيضة is an adjective. The color white, بيضة in Arabic, is an adjective, and when a noun is followed by an adjective, you don't need to pronounce the temarvuta. So you don't say siyarat bayda, you say siyara bayda. But Porsche is a noun, so when you have a noun plus another noun, you have to pronounce the temarvuta. That's why we say siyarat Porsche. Let's go and see what more there is. There is a Christmas tree here. Heidi shajrat Eid al-Milad. Heidi, this shajrat. Again, it has a temarbuta that I'm pronouncing. Heidi shajrat Eid al-Milad. This is the Christmas tree. I said, it's a blue tree, white blue, or it's not very clear. What is it? It's actually white mixed with blue. So heidi shajra bayda. Zara. Zara means blue, bayda means white, and bayda is the feminine form of abyad, which is white, and zara is the feminine form of azra, which is blue. Okay, this place looks full of furniture. So furniture in Arabic is farish, farish. So honi fi farish, farish bit, farish bit, which means furniture of home, which means furniture. We can do another lesson on furnitures, but for now let's continue our walk. Here too there is furniture. Hon kamen, hon kamen fi farish. Hon kamen, here also, which means here too. Hon kamen fi farish. Laiko hadi siyara sauda. Laiko. Laiko is the imperative form of look, and I'm talking to many people, I would say laiko. Laiko hadi siyara sauda. Shu halwa. How beautiful it is. It has some very unique stones, I don't know, but it's really beautiful. كتير حلوة هيدي السيارة السوداء كتير حلوة. يلا وهيدا محل شنط, and this is a shop of bags. هيدا محل شنط, هيدا محل شنط, هيدي شنطة سفر قديمة, هيدي شنطة سفر قديمة. So what I said is this is a shop of bags. شنط is bags, but شنطة is one bag. هيدي شنطة سفر. I'm pronouncing the T مربوطة. Why? Because it's followed by the word سفر, which is a noun. So now we have a noun plus noun. That's why we say شنطة سفر. هيدي شنطة سفر قديمة. This is an old suitcase. This is an old suitcase. وهيدول شنط. These are bags. If I want to say these are colored bags, I say هيدول شنط ملونة. So when I said هيدول شنط ملونة, ملونة with a T مربوطة is a feminine adjective, and ملون is masculine. Why do I use a feminine adjective with the word شنط? Because this is something very strange for those of you who don't speak Arabic, and maybe it's not very common to do this in other languages. But what we do is that when we have a word that is in the plural, any word that is in the plural and it's non-human plural, we treat it as if it's a feminine singular word. So the word shunat is a plural word, but it has to take a feminine singular adjective. Just because it's a plural word and it's a plural of non-humans, it's bags, it's not humans. So shunat mlawane. Mlawane is a feminine adjective. Mlawan is masculine. So shunat mlawane. And this is a pub, وهيدا pub. In Arabic, you're not gonna say something else. You will just say pub, وهيدا pub. Actually, pubs are very, very, very famous in the UK because almost in every corner you have pubs. People love going to pubs after work, at night, any time of the day. So pubs are part of British culture. So how do we say pubs are part of British culture? We're gonna say البابيت, because it's in the plural, البابيت من الثقافة البريطانية. من الثقافة البريطانية. ثقافة in Arabic means culture. بريطانية means British, and ثقافة is a feminine word, so we need a feminine adjective, which is British. So بريطانية is feminine, بريطاني is masculine. So البابيت من الثقافة البريطانية. Pubs are from the British culture. Let's go. هيدا بوسابا هو مطعم ياباني. It is a Japanese restaurant. هو مطعم ياباني كتير طيب. أكله كتير طيب. أكله. I said his food, which means its food. We don't have it in Arabic. We use he or she. So أكله, أكل means food. أكله means its food or his food. أكله كتير طيب. Its food is very tasty. هيدا مطعم ياباني أكله كتير طيب. واو شوفوا الزينة هون، شوفوا look in the plural، شوفوا الزينة هون، look at the decoration here. You remember the word the expression بتعقد، بتعقد is so amazing it gives you a complex. الزينة هون بتعقد. تعال معي come with me. شوفوا نحن هلأ بساحة سانت كريستوفر، نحن هلأ بساحة سانت كريستوفر، نحن هلأ بساحة سانت كريستوفر. So نحن means we، هلأ now، be in ساحة، in the square of بساحة سانت كريستوفر. هي ساحة كتير حلوة، it is a very beautiful square. هي ساحة كتير حلوة، فيها it has، فيها it has مطاعم كتير، it has lots of restaurants، فيها مطاعم كتير. مثلا هيدا مطعم تركي، this is a Turkish restaurant، هيدا مطعم تركي. وهيدا كارلوتشوز، كارلوتشوز مطعم إيطالي، هيدا كمان مطعم إيطالي، كمان means also، هيدا كمان مطعم إيطالي. وهيدا هونيك مطعم اسمه سفرة، سفرة مطعم لبناني؟ اوكي. وهيدا مطعم اسمه its name is سفرة، وسفرة مطعم إيراني، مطعم إيراني. وهيدا بريت ا مانجي، بريت ا مانجي is just a coffee shop، بس كافيه ببيع أكل وساندويشات، ببيع it sells، ببيع أكل it sells like any food، ببيع أكل وساندويشات. And to finish for today, let me finally show you the beautiful Christmas tree. It's a big Christmas tree. وهيدي شجرة كبيرة، هيدي شجرة كبيرة. فيها طابات، it has balls. فيها in it, which means it has. فيها طابات، it has balls. So one ball means طابة. طابات is in the plural. فيها طابات ذهبية، ذهبية it comes from the word ذهب، ذهب means gold، ذهبية means golden. فيها طابات ذهبية، فيها أدوية. And what else does it have? I think that's it. كتير حلوة الزينة، the decoration is very beautiful. I loved this tree means أنا كتير حبيت هيدي الشجرة، أنا كتير حبيت I loved هيدي الشجرة this tree. And finally I want to say I love Christmas. أنا كتير بحب عيد الميلاد، أنا كتير بحب عيد الميلاد. That's it for today. I hope you enjoyed it. And if you did, don't forget to follow me on Instagram, follow me on Facebook, and subscribe to my channel if you find my videos useful. Also, as usual, I will ask you to do your homework for today, to write down all the sentences we did in the comment box below. And if you have any questions, don't hesitate to ask. Thank you very much. Merci كتير. ويلا باي. مع السلامة. Bye.